अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर चिल्ड्रन, आई एम हियर विद द सेकंड पार्ट ऑफ दिस फिफ्थ लेसन, दैट इज फिजिकल फीचर्स ऑफ इंडिया। एंड इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द डिफरेंट लैंड फॉर्म्स। व्हाट आर द डिफरेंट लैंड फॉर्म्स वी हैव सीन? वी हैव लर्न अबाउट द नॉर्दर्न माउंटेन्स। नाउ लेट्स कंटिन्यू द रिमेनिंग लैंड फॉर्म्स। ओके, सो द सेकेंड वन इज द प्लेन्स ऑफ द नॉर्थ। टुवर्ड्स द साउथ ऑफ द हिमालयास लाइज द नॉर्दर्न प्लेन्स ऑफ इंडिया। दीज आर फ्लैट लैंड्स फॉर्म्ड बाय द फर्टाइल सॉइल लेफ्ट बिहाइंड बाय द हिमालयन रिवर्स। Let's have a glance over the map. So towards the south of the Himalayas lies the northern plain, it seems. This is the green part. What is green part? The plains of the north, isn't it? So it is extended here. So these are the northern plains of India, okay? So these are the flat lands formed by the fertile soil left behind by the Himalayan rivers. So actually these northern plains, they are formed by the fertile... These are the flat lands and it is formed by the fertile soil. What is the meaning of fertile? Fertile means an area which is good for growing crops, okay, which is rich in soil, okay. So these are flat lands formed by the fertile soil left behind by the Himalayan rivers. So these flat lands are actually formed by the Himalayan rivers. This fine soil is called silt and is good for growing different kinds of crops. So this type of soil which is good for growing crops is called silt, S-I-L-T, silt, okay. And a lot of people live in the northern plains. They are villages, towns and cities. You can see different villages and towns and cities in northern plains, and it is good land for growing crops also. It is generally very hot in summers and cold in winters in the plains. So it is according to the season. It is very hot in the summers and very cold in the winters. The next is the Thar Desert. The Great Indian Desert or the Thar Desert lies in the northwestern parts of India. So look at the map here. The Thar Desert is this blue color, okay? So it lies towards the northwestern part of the India. Northwest, you can see it is near both the directions, north and west. So that is why we are calling it as it lies in the, our Thar Desert lies in the north and west part of India, okay? It covers a lot of the state of Rajasthan, and it has a lot of these Rajasthan state in it. And the desert area is hot and dry. Of course, what is desert, children? Look at the picture here. It will be all the all around will be soil only, and there will be no water. Only rare, you can find water very rare. Okay, so it will be very very hot in Rajasthan, and it is covered with soil only. It covers the desert area is hot and dry. It is very hot and it is very dry in Rajasthan, seems. And at times sandstorms blow to cover everything. And sometimes what happens, sandstorms come. Storms means a huge wind will blow and it will cover everything. That is called as a sandstorm. Okay. And sometimes sandstorm also occur in this Rajasthan. It does not rain very often in the desert. Of course, it does not rain in the desert. Very, very often it does not rain in the desert. Water is less and people staying there often need to walk a long way to fetch water from deep wells. So the people living in this Thar Desert, they feel very difficulty. I mean, they face very, very much problems of drinking water. Why? Because if they need water, then they need to travel long distance to fetch a water. So to get the water, they need to travel long distances. Since the soil is dry and water is hard to get, it is difficult to grow plants and trees in the desert. Because of this hotness in the Rajasthan, it is difficult to grow any crop, isn't it, children? If you for example you take our summer, in summers usually what will happen, our if it is very hot, our plants get dried, isn't it, and they die, isn't it? So because of this hotness in the Thar Desert, the plants can't grow, it seems. Because of that reason, so it is difficult to grow plants and trees in the desert. And do you know a fact, children, that an oasis is an area of a desert? In desert there is an area that is called as oasis, and that place has water and some plants growing around it. Only oasis is a place in the desert where you can see few plants grown there, and there will be some water, okay. And it can be big or small. Sometimes oasis will be big, so, and in few places it will be big, in few places it will be small. These places provide rest, shade, food and water for the people who travel through hot sandy desert. And these oases is a good place for the people traveling in the Rajasthan, so that they can rest there and they can feel good under the shade, and they can eat some food and water, and whatever the needs they have they can get there. Okay, now let's check out the next one. The next landform is the Deccan Plateau. Plateau is an area of flat land that is higher than the land around it. Okay, so what is plateau? Plateau means it will be higher, it will be above the ground like this, and the like a mountain only, but the top will be flat. Usually the mountains will be like this, na children, but plateaus, if you find the hills with this flat surface, then we call it as a plateau. Plateau, plateau. So plateau is an area of the flat land that is higher than the land around it, yet in most places it does not rise as high as mountain or a hill that ends in a peak. So in most of the places actually does not rise very high, it seems like a mountain or hills, and it is more like a raised tabletop. How the table will be at the top like this, na flat. So plateau will be having the top like this, tabletop, okay, raised tabletop. A peninsula is a landform that reaches out into the sea. And what is peninsula? Peninsula means an area of land. For example, this is a land, so the three sides will be water only, children. Three sides, this side and this side will be water only. So this area, this land will be called as peninsula. Okay, a peninsula is a landform that reaches out into the sea, and it will reaches out into the sea. For example, you take this is a this is a sea, and these three part will be water, and it will reach into the sea. It is surrounded by water on three sides, but is joined to the mainland on one side. And three sides will be, it will be surrounded by water, and to the one side it will be connected with the land, okay, mainland. That is called as peninsula. What is plateau? Plateau means short hills, but the flat top will be flat. That is called as a plateau. And peninsula means three sides will be water, and one side it will be connected with the mainland. That is called as a peninsula. Okay, now hope that is clear. A large part of southern India is a peninsula and a plateau. What does it mean? Let's check out this map. Look at the picture here. Where is Deccan Plateau? It is pink in color. So this whole pink is where it is lying towards the south direction. So the large part of the India, southern India, has peninsula and plateau only. You can see, you can find many peninsula and plateaus in this part, southern part of India. Okay, why we are calling southern part? Why? Because it is towards the south direction. Okay. In fact, it is known as the Great Indian Peninsula or the Deccan or Southern Plateau. So that in fact it is also known as, it seems, Great Indian Peninsula or Deccan or the Southern Plateau. Now look at the map on page 31. You can see that the Deccan Plateau is surrounded by the Arabian Sea. Look at the map, page number 31. So Deccan Plateau is surrounded by, look at the map here. The Deccan Plateau is this pink part, na? So it is surrounded by which sea? This is Arabian Sea. Okay, and also it is surrounded by the Arabian Sea, Bay of Bengal and the Indian Ocean on the three sides. So look at here, this big Deccan Plateau is surrounded by three water bodies. What are there? First one is Arabian Sea, the next is Bay of Bengal, and also this is Indian Ocean. Okay, so it is surrounded by three sides with the water only. That is why we are calling it as Deccan Plateau. Okay. The plateau has many rivers that water the area. Of course, the plateau has many rivers in it, and that will give the water to that area. And however, these areas are not as fertile as the plains, but when compared to the plains, the area will not be fertile. Fertile means land which is good for growing crops. So it is not that much good like compared to the plains. Okay, some of these rivers are the Godavari, the Krishna and Kaveri, and the Narmada and Tapi. The Satpura and the Vindhya ranges of hills in central India separate the Deccan Plateau from the plains of north. Now the rivers that you can see in the Deccan Plateau are this one, Narmada, okay, Tapi, Godavari, Krishna, Kaveri. So these are the rivers you can find in the Deccan Plateau. Okay, and the Satpura and Vindhya ranges of hills, it seems it is in central India. It will separate the Deccan Plateau from the plains of the north. Now I would like to end up my discussion, and we'll catch up in the next video with the last part of this lesson. Till that, stay connected, stay safe, Allah Hafiz.